Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain Lamb. This movie tells the story of a couple who discover a strange and unnatural newborn in their sheep barn. They decide to raise her as their own, but sinister forces are determined to return the creature to the wilderness that birthed her. What mystery is hidden behind this film? Let's find out in Lamb. Lamb begins when a herd of horses is feared by an unknown creature who is about to head to a farm. The flock of sheep on the farm looked frightened, realizing the threat of danger lurking behind the door. Not long after, a ewe emerged from behind the door with an enlarged stomach and finally fell limply. The next day, the owner of the farm, a man named Ingvar, went about his usual activities to take care of his livestock. Ingvar lived at the foot of a mountain in Iceland with his wife, Maria. In that cold and remote area, they live alone without any neighbors. However, both of them seem to enjoy their lives, which are always busy taking care of a large number of farm animals as well as pets such as dogs and cats. Even though they have not been blessed with a child, Ingvar and Maria's household life is quite harmonious. They were getting ready in the afternoon because one of the ewes was about to give birth. They assisted in the delivery of the lamb and prepared a new cage for the mother and the two newborn lambs. After that, the two of them returned to their normal activities. Nothing odd happened. Everything looks normal. Ingvar was very happy because his sheep looked fat and healthy, and Maria, who never complained, to help her husband take care of his livestock. Until one day, another lamb was born from the same mother. Unlike the two lambs born earlier, Ingvar and Maria treated the newborn lamb as if it were their own newborn. Mary covered the lamb's body with a blanket to keep it warm and, instead of giving it to its mother to nurse, she took the lamb into the house and placed it near her bed. The next day, Ingvar prepared a crib that would later be used for the lamb's bed. On the other hand, Maria took care of the lamb with the love of her own child. She did not even heed the frustrated bleating of the mother lamb, who was looking for the whereabouts of its child. Seeing his wife, who loved the sheep so much, Ingvar was moved because he had never seen Maria look so happy. However, unbeknownst to Maria, Ingvar often wept in his solitude. As time went on, Maria and Ingvar grew more and more fond of and cared for the lamb and had considered it like their own biological child. They even gave it a name, namely Ada. On the other hand, the mother sheep continues to look for the whereabouts of its baby, always wandering outside the couple's house as if knowing that its lamb is in the house. Ingvar tried to push it away, and Maria tried to ignore it. Day after day, Ada continues to grow rapidly and is also healthy, even faster than the other two lambs that were born first. One day, Ingvar and Maria, who had just returned from the farm, did not find Ada in the house. Aiden looked for the lamb around the house and farm, but Ada is nowhere to be found. After hours of searching, they finally found Ada with her mother in the meadow. Ingvar immediately covered Ada's body so she wouldn't get cold, while Maria, who was already panicking over Ada's disappearance, was even angry at the mother lamb that gave birth to Ada. Because Ada is a hybrid sheep whose head is sheep while her body is human, she can walk on two legs like a human. Maria and Ada's closeness is like that of a mother with her daughter, where Maria even often talks to Ada, even though Ada can't respond to her words verbally. On the other hand, Ingvar was also getting used to the closeness of Maria and Ada, and even he himself developed the same affinity with Ada. Meanwhile elsewhere, a man appears to be forcibly removed from a car and abandoned in the middle of a mountain road. Having no other choice, the man walked through the valleys and meadows. Shortly after the incident where Ada went missing and was later found next to her mother, Maria often had nightmares in which she was terrorized by a flock of sheep. Because the nightmare made her very depressed, she decided to take desperate measures to end the nightmare. While Ingvar and Ada were still asleep in their beds, Maria took her rifle and walked over to the mother lamb in the morning. Maria immediately shot the mother lamb without hesitation and dragged its body away from the house and the farm. After that, she dug the ground, then buried the body of the mother lamb, without putting a mark on it. However, unbeknownst to Maria, the man who had been forcibly removed from the car, who arrived at Ingvar's farmhouse shortly before the murder, witnessed Maria's actions. After Maria returned to the house, the abandoned man entered the barn and decided to spend the night there. The next day, Ingvar, who entered the barn, met the man and did not look surprised to see him because he turned out to be Petter, Ingvar's older brother. Ingvar then invited him to eat together in the house. Although Petter had visited Ingvar's house many times, this was the first time that he had seen anyone other than Ingvar and his wife. Moreover, the figure is very unusual in appearance because it has a sheep's head with a human body. It was hard enough for Petter to think of Ada as a human, even though Ingvar and Maria told him to treat Ada like his own niece. Petter decided to stay temporarily at Ingvar's house because he was involved in a complicated problem that caused him to be abandoned on the streets. Petter often helps the couple take care of their farm and ranch. Maria tries to be patient even though Petter is constantly making sexual advances when she is alone. On the other hand, Ingvar's cat and pet dog, always seemed to be looking into the distance as if realizing that something out there was watching Ingvar and Maria's house. One day, assisted by Petter, the husband and wife were cleaning the warehouse. While relaxing, Petter, who believes that Ada is an animal, not a human, idly feeds her with a handful of grass. Ingvar, who saw Petter's actions, immediately became angry and then carried Ada. The brothers then got into an argument. Petter thought Ingvar and Maria had gone insane by treating the lamb like a human child. But Ingvar replies that he doesn't care and claims that Ada's presence has given them happiness, which is enough for him. Petter, increasingly angry and disturbed by Ingvar and Maria's strange attachment to Ada, then takes Ada for a morning walk while they are still asleep. Petter intends to kill Ada for the sake of a normal life for Ingvar. However, when he was about to shoot Ada, he didn't even have the heart after Ada looked at him with innocent eyes. After a tearful change of heart, he returned home with Ada. Maria, who didn't find Ada on her bed, then saw Petter sleeping soundly on the sofa, hugging Ada. Since then, Petter grew accustomed to Ada, and just like Ingvar and Maria, he also began to treat Ada like a normal human child and often spent time with her like an uncle with his niece. They also went together driving Ingvar's old tractor, which broke down, so that Petter and Ada had to go home on foot from the meadow, not far from their farm. On the other hand, Maria is seen visiting the cemetery area and praying solemnly. As it turned out, Maria and Ingvar loved Ada so much because they had a baby girl named Ada in the past. Ada had not yet been born because Maria had problems with her pregnancy and was forced to abort her womb. The miscarriage left her so traumatized to this day that she was too scared to get pregnant and give birth again. One day, Maria, Ingvar and Petter were seen relaxing together while watching a sports match. After that, they had a small party in the living room and drank until they got drunk. Maria tried to invite Ada to dance, but the lamb didn't seem interested and decided to go out of the house. When she was outside the house, Ada accidentally saw an unknown creature near the barn who was about to kill Ingvar's pet dog. After staring at each other for a moment, the creature then proceeded to kill the dog before entering the barn and stealing Ingvar's weapon. Ada, looking terrified, ran straight into the house and crawled into Ingvar's arms, who had fallen asleep from being too drunk. After Ingvar had slept soundly in his room, Petter began to sexually approach Maria once again. When Maria again rejects the drunken Petter, the man reveals that he witnessed Maria killing Ada's mother and tries to blackmail her into having sex with him by threatening to reveal this to Ingvar as well as Ada. However, Maria was not daunted by the threat of Petter. She then pretended to be seduced by Petter's seduction until she finally managed to lock him in the warehouse. Maria then played the piano to drown out Petter's screams as well as her own cries. The following day, after making sure Ingvar and Ada were still asleep in bed, Maria then went to Petter and asked him to go with a large backpack. Shortly after they left, Ingvar and Ada finally woke up. The two then had breakfast together like father and daughter. Not being able to find Maria and Petter anywhere, Ingvar then decided to fix a broken tractor that was not far from their farm. On the other hand, Maria actually took Petter to the bus stop and sent him home after giving him quite a lot of money. Maria said that she and Ingvar loved Ada as much as their own children and did not want Ada to be sad or suffer in the slightest. Maria asked Petter to shut his mouth about the incident and let her family live happily with Ada. Petter, who was touched by Maria's sincerity, finally melted and decided to leave. Upon returning home, Maria did not find the whereabouts of Ingvar and Ada anywhere. Not long after, Maria heard the sound of gunfire and she immediately rushed to the meadow where the gunshots had come from. Meanwhile in the meadow, the form of the creature that had been stalking Ingvar and Maria's house was finally revealed to be a ram hybrid with a human body. The creature shot Ingvar in the neck, then carried the crying Ada and walked away into the wilderness. Before taking his death, Ingvar tried to defend Ada so that the creature did not take her away. But he finally breathed his last. Maria then finds Ingvar's body in the meadow. She mourned the death of her husband while crying hysterically and trying to call out Ada, who had disappeared somewhere. The film ends by showing Maria still in shock over her husband's death, wandering through the wilderness, before finally facing the camera and closing her teary eyes.